Good to have you with us. You're watching The Big Story. I'm Avni Raja, and our focus is going to be on the situation in the National Capital and National Capital Region, which is where the air pollution is spiraling out of control, the air quality worsening day after day, along with the COVID surge as well. We're going to focus on that and ask some extremely pertinent questions at this point in time. Just to give you a background about what's happening right now, air quality in Delhi continuing to remain severely polluted for the second straight day. Since yesterday, Delhi has recorded the worst air quality since November last year. In fact, air quality in the whole of the National Capital Region has tanked much ahead of Diwali. Yesterday, the Delhi government banned all kinds of crackers, including green crackers, until the end of the month. The rise in air pollution is particularly concerning because it has led to an increase in COVID cases, COVID risk as well. Delhi has been seeing a surge in COVID cases for several days now. In fact, the number of deaths also in the 24-hour period is 66, which is the highest in the past 4 months. And the number of COVID cases also recording 6,700. In fact, Delhi Health Minister has appealed to everyone to wear a mask. Listen in first.
पोल्यूशन भी और कोविड भी दोनों ही चीज़ें दोनों अपने आप में खतरनाक हैं और मुझे लगता है पोल्यूशन से बचने के लिए भी और कोविड से बचने के लिए भी मुझे लगता है कम से कम नवंबर के महीने में तो कसम खा लें कि मास्क के बिना बाहर नहीं निकलेंगे. मास्क इज योर वैक्सीन. जब तक वैक्सीन नहीं आती उसको वैक्सीन की तरह से यूज़ करें, मास्क को जरूर लगाएं. और बहुत सारे लोग उसको बड़े लाइटली ले रहे हैं, सोच रहे हैं कि कुछ नहीं है जी, ये तो कोई बात ही नहीं है जी. अगर ऐसी महामारी आई है तो ठीक है, अगर एक साल पटाखे नहीं भी जलाएंगे. मैं तो कह रहा हूँ भगवान का पूजन करो. दिवाली के दिन पटाखे जलते हैं तो रात के 3-4-5 घंटे सांस भी नहीं लिया जाता है, इतना बुरी हालत हो जाती है.
Alright, let me introduce my guests who are joining us today. Dr. Shalabh Sharma, pulmonologist and senior ENT surgeon at Sir Gangaram Hospital, and Reena Gupta, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party. Thank you both of you for joining us. But before I go across to our guests, I want to go across to my colleague Alok, who's joining us, so who has been tracking all of these developments with respect to pollution. Alok, what can you tell us right now? Of course, the fact is that these warnings did come in much earlier. The fact that winter is, weeks ago that winter was going to come and that the pollution levels are going to spike, and it is a big risk as far as COVID cases are concerned. And that's exactly what has happened. All the warnings are, in fact, playing out just as, we were talking about. But the situation is very bad, not just in Delhi, but in the entire NCR region.
Yes, Avni. In fact, right now I'm standing at one of the places in the national capital. This is central part of Delhi, near Pragati Maidan, and this is a ring road which I'm showing it to you. There is underpass that is being constructed. First, I would like to show you the visuals, what is present situation at the ground. In fact, you can see all over around there is a construction activity is going on. Remember, the pollution level is not only because of the stubble burning, because of vehicular movement, but a major factor is also that is the dust pollution. And here you can see that a lot of dust and smoke. Yes, we all know that the smoke is just because of the stubble burning and other factors as well. Vehicular movement is huge all over around this particular area. This is very busy road, and here it's a construction work is going on. This is underpass is being constructed. There is one anti-smog gun is also parked over here. You can see this anti-smog gun, which is supposed to be continuously running, but that is not being run. You can see clearly that it is now stopped. When we asked the authorities, they said that in the morning or the peak hours they run, but not permanently, because that anti-smog gun helps in decreasing the dust level from the environment. And there is the particles of the water comes out regularly, so it helps in decreasing the pollution level, but that is not being happening. So this kind of thing is happening. If we talk particularly all across the city or the NCR region, in the national capital around 60 such anti-smog guns are placed at various places. But if you see, if you go and if you visit these places, sometimes it's found to be running, sometimes it does not found to be running. So this kind of things are happening. Apart from that, if you talk about the pollution level continues to be increasing daily, and in fact today it's already reached into the severe category level. Definitely Delhi government is saying that they are doing a lot. Recently they have banned the firecrackers, all kinds of firecrackers, despite the green cracker that was allowed by the Supreme Court. despite that. So, in fact, the Delhi government also come out with a plan that red light on, gaadi off, but that is also not working on the ground. When we visit on the streets, on the red lights, we see that the people are not shutting their vehicles. So definitely, Delhi government is trying to do, but Avni, the important part here is that there are various other factors which are not temporary. There are various other factors which are continuously on year for continuously for 12 months. That is the vehicular movement. We all know that number of vehicles are increasing daily, and Delhi government does not able to come. They have not able to come so far with the better policy. Remember, EPCA has also identified, they have noticed, and they have also written to the Delhi government as well to come up with a better parking policy and as well as the better transport policy. The number of buses are not increased in the national capital, so people are relying on their private vehicles. So that's why private vehicles are very high in the national capital, and in fact, they are contributing around 28% of pollution in the national capital. So definitely, this is an alarming situation. This situation not comes right now. Whatever the Delhi government is claiming again and again that pollution is continuously happening just because of the stubble burning, we can say that it is contributing pollution. 40% of pollution is coming right now from the stubble burning, but not only that one factor. There are various factories, illegal factories are also running all across the city and in fact in the national capital region as well. Despite that, so all these factors come to and they are the reasons of the pollution in the national capital. The authorities need to look into it. Back to you.
All right, Alok, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. In fact, since this morning, there has been a thick haze, thick smog across the national capital and the NCR region. But let me now bring in my guests who are with me. Dr. Sharma, if I can come to you first, what can you tell us about how bad the situation is and what kind of a risk are we seeing? We're obviously seeing what's happening in terms of the spike in COVID cases in Delhi right now and over the last few days, along with the pollution levels, which are just worsening, and also the fact that the winter itself has set in earlier than otherwise it does.
Yeah. There is the pollution levels right now are horrendous, actually. At 400, 500 levels, you're talking about levels where it's actually not really compatible with human life. If I was to quote studies, there are studies that show that even a 1 point increase in 2.5 p.m. and especially even 5 points increase in 2.5 p.m., p.m. 2.5 is associated with an increased risk of dying early death. And that usually comes from all the other problems that come with this, that is like heart disease, lung disease, and the pollutants that you inhale are, you know, some of them, there are some heavy metals there, some polyfluorocarbons from petrol, fuel, and all of that accumulates in the body and can cause cancers as far away as in the liver and the kidney. There's also been a very interesting study in the US where they found that a single point rise in 2.5 PM, 2.5 is associated with an increase in the number of cases of early Alzheimer's disease, dementia, presenile dementia, Parkinson's. And these are definite associations. These are not that they are just thinking about it. They've actually found the association. And surprisingly, they were able to find association down to just a single digit level increase in PM 2.5. So right now in my home, I've had the air purifier on since I left in the morning for the hospital and got back. Outside it's about 400, I suppose, but inside now with the air purifier on this morning, it's about 66 PM 2.5. So even now it's in the poor category or the moderate category, because indoor it should be less than 50 or 49 PM 2.5. So we are living in very difficult times. This happens every year, and as the years go by, we are going to be inhaling all of this and keeping this inside us. You have to understand that these pollutants don't leave our body. They don't come in, and then when the pollution levels are low, they release from the body or they exhale, they come out in the exhalation. It doesn't happen. These are cumulatively getting deposited in the different organs of the body and causing damage, and they are known carcinogens and known reasons for cancer and lots of other diseases. And I just hope that in the next couple of years, the government of India, the central government, along with the state government and the Supreme Court of India are able to bring down enough laws and their implementation that we can actually have healthier lives. My son plays soccer every year, and since the last year he stopped playing. And winter is actually the time when you go to play. I mean, you go to play outdoor sports because it's cold, the weather is nice, but the pollution levels are too much. It's toxic. I've been cycling in the evenings until a couple of days ago. I wear a PM 2.5. I wear a proper N95 mask when I cycle. But now I've stopped since day before yesterday, since the pollution levels have shot up so much.
Yes, absolutely. That is, of course, a lot of very important points that you have mentioned, Dr. Sharma. But if I can also now go across to Reena Gupta as well. Reena Gupta, there has been a series of measures that have been announced by the Delhi government, which includes things like anti-dust campaign, promoting electric vehicle, the red light on gaadi off campaign, anti-smog guns at various hotspot, pollution control teams. But if you can tell us, you know, a lot of this is still doesn't seem to be completely implemented properly. And the other part, of course, is whether this is really enough. Because, for example, a large chunk of the entire issue of pollution is because of the increased vehicular movement. It is also because of the stubble burning, among other things. So what is the implementation process of all of these measures?
So, Avni, allow me some time to explain the whole issue properly. Pollution in Delhi, if you were to treat Delhi as a center and you draw a circle around Delhi, what we call is an airshed. So anything which is happening in around at least 300 kilometers radius of Delhi impacts the air quality in the state of Delhi or in the city of Delhi. So it is not just what the Delhi government does. It is also what the governments around Delhi do and what the central government helps, enables the state governments around Delhi to do. Only then we can overcome the pollution in Delhi. Having said that, if you look at the whole of North India, actually, every year the same phenomena occurs. I was just looking at the PM levels in Banaras, Lucknow, Kanpur, Muzaffarnagar, Meerut. All of these places, Delhi, Gurgaon, they're all showing very high pollution levels. Because what happens is in winters, because of temperature inversion and also because a lot of farmers burn the stubble, those two things added together take the pollution levels to very severe category. So unless the central government takes pollution and air quality as an important policy and not an afterthought, you know, we will not be able to make a dent in air pollution across the North India. And year in and year, every year will come and we'll discuss the same issue. It has to be year round. There has to be a focus from the government of India. But I'm very disappointed to say that I don't see the government of India actually doing much to control air pollution. You know, it's just to give you an example. They have recently given clearance to a power plant in Khurja, which makes no economic sense, no environment sense. I've looked at all the data. You can actually get much cheaper electricity from solar plants rather than having the power plant in Khurja. So unless as a country, and you know, the onus really lies on central government, we start treating air pollution as something that we tackle at the national level, at a policy level, and we don't treat it as an afterthought, just something that we need to take care of, you know. The World Bank came out with a report of a couple of years ago.
Reena Gupta, if I may interrupt you, this is a constant issue. I mean, every year, this is the same conversation. This blame game goes on. This politicization goes on. And every time, it's only when things reach such dire levels that suddenly, the government seem to wake up and start putting things into place. How much effect is actually a cracker ban going to have when the pollution levels are so bad, so much before Diwali? How much of a difference is it actually going to make? Or whether you know the Gaadi Off sort of campaign which has been launched, how much of is that actually being implemented after the first few days where there was so much publicity around it? After that, how much of a track are you keeping whether all of that is actually being implemented? And B, how much is it actually going to work? The issue is much deeper than all of these band-aid solutions. But I'm going to come back to this discussion. We're getting some breaking inputs right now. Now, Mirna has accessed the letter which the outgoing members of the EPCA, that is the Environment Pollution Control Authority, have written to the Union Environment Minister. Now, in this letter, the members cited the things that have been done and what further needs to be done to fight pollution in the Delhi NCR region. The authority has listed that Delhi and NCR needs a better parking policy. Buses need to be increased. A long-term solution for solid and biomedical waste is also needed. Remember, EPCA has been dissolved now with the formation of the Commission for Air Quality. Let me, in fact, go across to Alok to get us some more details about what other points this entire letter mentions. Alok, over to you. Take us through what are the important highlights that this mentions.
Environment Pollution Control Authority, that was appointed 20 years ago. And in fact, that was under the supervision of the Supreme Court. Now it has been dissolved because of the formation of the commission. Remember, the commission has been constituted and the chairperson has also been appointed. But if you see this EPCA, after being dissolved, the EPCA members have written this letter to the Union of Environment Minister stating about various things need to be done in the National Capital Region. And they specifically mentioned about the stubble burning. Yes, stubble burning is the reason. The other five primary reason is that one is that the Delhi government and the other government, state governments, need to be done is the parking policy. Remember, Avni, that we all know that number of vehicles are increased in Delhi and NCR. So if the parking price is increased, then definitely people will not buy their cars and they will start relying on the transport. Apart from that, the second point, this is very important point, that is about the buses which I was already speaking about. These are the buses, these are the DTC buses which are supposed to be increased in the National Capital Region. In fact, if you talk particularly about Delhi, that there are only around 6,500 buses presently in the fleet. But this should be supposed to be around 11,000. So government should need to come out with that policy. So the EPCA has mentioned about the policy regarding the transport policy. And apart from that, the RFID system. This means that there should be electromagnetic system, that is about the vehicles which are entering in the national capital. Whenever they enter, they have to pay the toll. So when they stop their vehicle, they definitely emit the fuel, and that also increases the pollution. So if there is the electromagnetic system, then definitely they need not to stop at the toll plaza. This is also mentioned by the EPCA, and also long-term solution. Remember, there is the landfill sites, three landfill sites, that is also not being managed properly by the MCD, Municipal Corporation of Delhi. We, in fact, Mirror now exposed that how the landfill sites are still violating various environmental norms. There are no water sprinkling is happening. So this is also mentioned by the EPCA, and also action to control stubble burning that I already have mentioned. There is one more point, that complete ban of imported pet coke in industries. That pet coke that is still being used in the industries, that will also need to be checked by the authorities, but they are not able to do that. So these are the points which the EPCA has mentioned. Definitely, now the commission has been set up. We hope that the commission will put some regulation on these things. Back to you.
All right, Alok, thank you for getting us all of those details. Yes, that is, of course, the hope that this commission does put in place a lot of these measures that haven't been done as yet. But let me go back to my guest now. Dina Gupta, you just heard our reporters, you know, list out the various issues, the various things that still haven't been done at this point in time. What would you like to say? What's your response to all of this?
So, Avni, the EPCA letter, I've looked at the EPCA letter. It is not just for Delhi government. It's for all the NCR region governments, which means UP, Delhi, Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan. As far as Delhi government is concerned, pet coke is not being used in Delhi anymore. We are the only state in the whole NCR region that has moved all of our industries to better fuel. There are gensets are not being allowed in Delhi. We are giving 24/7 electricity. And we've shut down all our power plants, whereas the neighboring states of Punjab and Haryana have not shut down the polluting power plants. And just going back to what your reporter was saying earlier about the dust issue, you know, we realize that dust is also one of the reasons why air pollution goes up. And that is the reason why we've launched the Green Delhi app, because we want to involve the citizens of Delhi in helping us identify where are the dust emanating sources and help us close those down. So, you know, the Delhi government is the only government which is actually taking everything which is in its control every step, whether it's big or small, whether it's coming out with an electric vehicles policy, whether it's shutting down of power plants, whether it's actually experimenting with a bio decomposer, whereas we hardly have any parali in Delhi. So, you know, we've taken all of these steps, but I'm really sorry to say that unless we have, you know, cooperation from the central government and we have cooperation from the neighboring states of Delhi, Delhi will continue to suffer, because 64% of the pollution in Delhi actually emanates from sources which are outside Delhi. And this is not something that I am saying. This is the report which the Tata Energy Research Institute has come out Reena in 2018.
Gupta, even if you say that 64% emanates from sources which are outside Delhi, there is still a lot, like our reporter pointed out, a lot of things that aren't being done in Delhi itself. Why is it that we always are playing these blame games? The transport policy, for example, the number of buses, for example, the construction, that is the rules or ban on construction that is not being followed. Since morning, if you've seen our channel, we've been reporting from construction sites showing how the rules are being blatantly flouted. So all the time, instead of constantly, you know, making these blame games, there is a lot more that needs to be still done by the Delhi government. But I want to go back to Dr. Sharma here. Dr. Sharma, just help us put this into a little bit more perspective in terms of the kind of rise that we're seeing in COVID cases right now. How worried are you and how dangerous is this? You know, because this is really, in my opinion, an emergency situation that we're looking at.
Yeah, because right now Delhi is anyway going through probably one of the worst phases in COVID infections. I have a huge number of COVID infections. The numbers being picked up, you have to understand, say about 7,000 to 8,000 a day. But you have to also understand there are a lot of patients who are people who are just getting mild infection, a little bit of cough, cold, fever for a day or two, and then settles down, and they're not getting themselves tested. So we are probably, if you multiply that figure with the actual figures, may actually run into multiples of tens of thousands a day coming positive. And I think with the increased pollution levels, there's definitely going to be a lot of pressure on the respiratory systems of these patients to try and come out of this infection. Unfortunately, they're not going to get the kind of clean air they should be breathing when they're trying to recover from these infections. And all the people who have difficulty breathing, imagine from COVID, and then on top of that, having to breathe this kind of air. It's a very, very difficult situation for Delhiites and for people who are admitted in the hospitals.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So you know, Reena Gupta, if we have time just for one more question from you. The fact is that people are still relying a lot on their private vehicles. If you can respond to the specific question as far as the transport policy and the buses are concerned.
So as far as the buses are concerned, as of now, we have 6,600 buses in Delhi. 1,100 have been added in the last 1 year. There has been an order for 4,000 buses, which has already been placed. They should arrive in the next month or so. And we have been writing to DDA, requesting them to please give us land for parking these buses. Because unless we have parking space, where are we going to park these buses? But it's been 2 years and they have not allotted us the parking space. So I hope they will listen to the request and allot the parking space as soon as possible.
Right. All right. Thank you so much, Reena Gupta and Dr. Sharma, for joining us with all of that perspective. I can only say that we hope that the governments do, in fact, come together without politicizing and without making this into a complete blame game and address the issue. Because at the end of the day, we are in the midst of a pandemic, and it is the people who are living in Delhi and the National Capital Region who are the biggest losers, the biggest sufferers in this entire issue. But on that note, we're completely out of time on this edition here. But here's a quick reminder that you can visit our website, mirrornownews.com, for news and updates, and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and Telegram as well. Thank you for tuning in.